There, welcome to video number two. This is where we left off in your notes. I was encouraging you to look for patterns based on this, the notes over on the right hand side, and hopefully you got a grasp of the idea there. There is another one we need to talk about, another special case of multiplication. Again, I'm going to allow you to do these in your head, and it looks like this. It's when we have a binomial multiplied by another binomial that notice they are exactly the same. The only difference is one is a plus sign and one is a minus sign. Okay, so that's a special type of product here that we're going to multiply. Let's watch what happens. Something interesting happens when we multiply. Let's just go through the process the old-fashioned way. So we multiply those two things right there and we get x squared. And then we multiply this term times that term, and we get minus 5x. And then we do the same thing with these. 5 times x is plus 5x. And 5 times negative 5 is minus 25. Now you may already see what's going to happen here. Notice we have minus 5 plus 5 are like terms. And that basically adds to 0. So those are eliminated, and we're left with x squared here minus 25. So that's it. That is the product of x minus 5. I'm sorry, x plus 5 times x minus 5. X squared minus 25. Notice that middle term canceled out because we had a negative and a positive like term. And that's always going to happen when you have this type of a setup. There's a special name for that. Allow me to show you. Let's do a dotted line there wherever you were in your notes. Copy this one down. This is the basic rule of the type that we're talking about here. So let's do the same thing here. Let's multiply this one out here and just watch what happens, and then we'll look at what the rule is. A times A is A squared. A times negative B is negative AB. That's just A times B. It's the only way we can write that. These two multiplied, that's a positive B times positive A, so we'll just call it positive AB. And then we have B times minus B, which would be minus B squared. So if we look right here, we can see that these two terms are like terms and they add to 0. So the only thing that's left is A squared minus B squared. And that pattern will always be true. Now notice, if A is this number and B is this number, all we have to do is square that value and square that value, put a minus sign in between them. That will always be a negative sign because this positive A here times this negative B will always be minus B squared. So here's the rule. All right, this form, A plus B times A minus B, got to have the parentheses in there, by the way, is A squared minus B squared. This is called a difference of squares. Put difference of squares, because what we have here is we have a perfect square A minus a perfect square B. Okay, you can look in your book for more information on page 506. Whoops, page 506. And this particular book calls it the product of a sum and difference. And again, you can read more and see more examples on page 506. A product means it's multiplied, a sum and a difference with the same values. Okay, let's look at a couple. So let's keep that in mind. So here are the notes you just wrote down. You should have that just one time in the description side. So let's use this form. All right, in this particular problem, okay, 2x is A, so A is 2x. And B is 4. Okay, you see the pattern? There's A and B. So that is A and that's B. So you can take A and square it. Okay, so A squared would equal 2x squared. You don't have to write all this out, but here's what we're doing in our head. 2x times 2x is 4x squared. Alright, so you have 4x squared. Always put a minus sign right there. Again, when you have the same numbers where one's a plus sign, one's a minus sign, always minus, and then it's B squared. Okay, B is 4. 4 squared is 16. That's the answer right there. You could multiply it out longhand if you wanted to. This times this, 4x squared. This times this, and this times this would give you plus 8x minus 8x. They're both gone. 4 times negative 4 is 16. So we should get to where we can do those in our head, hopefully based on this pattern and following those notes like I mentioned on page 506 right there. So that's really all I've got for you at this point. So that's what I want you practicing, math in your head. Okay, some of you are going to be really happy with that. And if you can, like I mentioned, get these patterns down, when we get to factoring, it's going to make your life a lot easier because we'll be doing that backwards. All right, that's your notes for today. I'll see you soon.